YouTube family. My name is Elysia English and welcome back to my channel. I love being able to make DIY home decor items because not only can I make them for less money, but I love the custom aspect that these pieces will have in my home. Today I'm working on a project for a client that I know she'll be able to keep that will be a timeless piece in her home. A couple of years ago, when I was running my handmade business, there was a trend that was super popular and everybody was making these in different workshops as well as just for their own home decor projects. I avoided this trend because I like to make things that are different than what other people are making. And so I actually didn't tackle one of these projects, even for my own self. And so when a client asked me last week if I would make one of these for her, I decided that it was time for me to give it a try. And so I'm really looking forward to today's project. Of course, as usual, I'm going to use upcycled materials. So this project is actually costing me under $7 to create, which I think is pretty amazing considering the cost that people were charging to have these made custom. Using some leftover wood from some other projects, a little bit of stain and paint that I have lying around, and just a $7 kit, I'm going to create a wood custom clock for my client. She had a really neat idea on what style she wanted for the numbers and the layout of her clock, which I think is really cool because it shows her personality wonderfully in this project. So I know she's going to love it at the end, so let's get creating. To get started, the first thing I'm going to do is prep these upcycled boards and get them ready for today's project. I have used some brad nails in these boards, and they're actually some wider boards that I used for a sign at one point using three different shiplap boards. As you can see, I created this sign using upcycled wood from another project, so we're reusing this wood again, and I'm going to take out all of the nails that are in it just using some wire cutters and make sure that this wood is prepped for me to do my next step, which will be able to put this together and create the round that I need for my clock.
I may have went a little overkill on the brad nails at some point.
It's so sunny out. The sun is blasting in my studio window and it's so nice today. I can't wait for spring and I'm just dying to have the sunlight coming in all the time because we've had some gloomy, like rainy and like sometimes snowy days. So I'm looking forward to the warm weather. I started with three boards that I was prepping to get ready to build my clock. And I realized that one of my boards had a little bit of a warp to it and I don't want that. So I'm actually going to cut two of them in half. That way I actually have four pieces to work with to be able to create the slats for my clock. So I'm going to use my miter saw and cut these in half. If you're new to my channel, I have a playlist on my channel that actually is a whole series on DIY wood rounds. We did a three-part series on how you can do wood rounds really easily doing different styles. And so during this video, since I'm using a slat process for my wood, I'm actually gonna make my own protractor to make my perfect circle and use my scroll saw to be able to cut it out. But if you check out my tutorial, I have some really unique tips on how you can make perfect round circles using different tools you have around the shop. I'll put the card above for you for the playlist. But what I'm going to do is use a recycled cardboard box here, and I'm going to create a cardboard protractor that's actually 9 inches across, because all I'm going to do is make an 18 inch wide circle. And so I want the circumference to be a total of 18 inches. And so I'm going to create one just so that I can do with a pen and a nail. Measuring back from my nail, I'm going to make a line at 9 inches, which is half of 18 inches, so that I can make a circle that's 18 inches wide.
9 inches.
I'm just going to poke a small hole with my writing utensil. You can use a pen or a pencil. Using my slats, I'm going to actually off-center just a little bit up from where one of my main slats is, because where I'm going to put the clock mechanism, I don't want to drill a hole right where my slats join together. So I'm just gonna offset it just a little bit, and I'm going to make sure that I have enough room all the way around for 9 inches, which I do. So I'm going to just push this in just a little bit because that is where I'm going to drill my hole. Perfect circle. My scroll saw is my absolute favorite tool that I have in my shop, and any excuse I can to use it is definitely a project that's right up my alley. I like to practice with it as much as possible, and being able to use it just makes me happy. I don't know, it just seems to be a tool that I've really fallen in love with in my shop. And so I'm going to use my scroll saw now and just follow all the lines on each of the slats so that I can make my circle. palm sander, I'm going to sand all of the edges of my round circle that I've created. Now that I have four slats, pretty happy with the way that they turned out. So I think this is going to be really nice for my clock. I just want to make sure they're really smooth before I apply some stain. So I'm going to do a painting technique to make this look like aged whitewash wood. I'm going to rub on some of my favorite provincial stain. I know that my client loves this stain color. She has some other accents in her kitchen that are this color. And so what I'm going to do is put some on the base of my clock. Then I'm going to paint it white and distress it. So some of her favorite wood tone comes showing through on the slats of the clock. So this actually looks like a really neat weathered wood, actually just the way that it is, but I'm going to paint each of these slats white and then let it dry. I might actually do two coats of the white, and once it's completely dry, I'm going to distress it with my palm sander, bringing in some of that wood color that we just stained through the white, so it looked like it has that little bit of a wood tone and the white aged wood look. Palm sander dust on my lashes. I'm just using pure white beauty tone paint to be able to paint the clock and one of my favorite Elysia English brushes. This is one of our new color launches. You can find these on my Etsy shop. I knew I was gonna get covered in paint. I knew it. I'm going to paint my sides as well, but I wanted to get a first base coat on the top and then I'll go around and do my edges. That way I don't have to flip it over because I don't want it to kind of get raised edges being stuck to the table or something by flipping it over. So I'm going to paint just a little bit in between each of the slats so that you don't see it when it's like ribbed together, as well as the outside once it dries a little bit. My white paint is all dry and I'm going to use my palm sander to distress all of the slats now to bring out some of that dark wood tone that I just put in. To attach my slats together, I'm going to do some back braces using 1x2s. The reason I've decided to use 1x2s on the back is because they're actually the same depth as a little mechanism that's going to be actually the hands of my clock. So that will actually stick out at the back. I'll show you at the end really more visually how that looks. So what I did was I've cut two pieces and I'm going to attach them onto my clock on the back. So I'm going to flip over all of my pieces and adhere them on with my brad nailer. And then I'm also going to add a little piece at the top here that her hanging mechanism can go on. So my two side slats are going to be like this so that they're equally on all of the slats. And then my hanging mechanism piece is going to go at the top so she can hang a hook to be able to hang up her clock. And the clock mechanism will be in the middle here and it won't stick out any further than these 1x2s here. So it will lay flush against the wall using the back braces. I visited my craft store to be able to find a clock movement kit. This one's by a company called Art Minds. They had a bunch of different companies. You want to make sure that you choose the kit that fits the depth of the wood that you're going to do. So my kit is for 3/4 inch thick wood, which is what my wood is. So you want to make sure, this was the first time buying a kit like this, so I really noticed that that was one of the details I had to pay attention to. So check out your craft stores for the thickness of the wood you plan on making the base of your clock in. And so I know that it has a center post here that I need to be able to put through my clock. So using that initial little nail pin hole that I had, which I used to make my diameter, I know that is the exact center point of my clock. And so using my drill and my drill bit, I'm going to drill a hole so that my mechanism can fit through that hole. I stacked a few pieces of scrap wood so that I don't drill a hole through my actual craft table here. And so now I'm going to follow my little nail pin hole that I had, center my drill bit, and then drill a hole. My client really wanted to do a unique style on how they were going to create the numbers on the clock. And so what I did was I made some in Roman numerals, some just regular traditional letter style, and then some written in a cursive. She showed me an example of one that she really liked, and so I recreated it using my Silhouette Cameo. Using my Silhouette Cameo, I created the design that I need for all of the numbers for my clock. Since I want the numbers to be different styles for my client, I made sure to fit them all in equally along the 18-inch circle that I'm going to create on wood.
That way I've made it kind of in real life size. So when I print it out, all I'm going to do is move my letters and move the circle out of the way so that all of my things are all together on one stencil. Moving all of the numbers together ensures that I'm not wasting a whole lot of plastic vinyl that I don't need to do. So if I put them all together, I can create a smaller stencil and then just lay them on my clock into place where I want them.
So using contact paper, I was able to print out all of the numbers that I needed, and now I'm going to transfer them onto my clock so that I can make the numbers on my clock black. I'm going to do my 12, 3, 6, and 9 because then I know I'll be able to space out my other numbers more evenly, just using that as kind of a template. Using a makeup sponge, I'm going to sponge using black paint. I like to use a really light amount of paint and just do a couple of passes. I go straight and use my black paint, but if you're looking for tips on how you can paint wood signs or clocks and things like this, you can follow my DIY painting with no bleeding. I have a video on my channel. I'm going to do this same transferring of all the numbers for the other 11 numbers and get back to you with the reveal. Sometimes when you create new projects, they end up being just one that you end up creating, and then sometimes you create something and you're realizing that you're probably gonna make a lot more of something. And I have a funny feeling that I'll be designing quite a few more clocks in my near future because this clock turned out amazing and I know my client's gonna love it, and I know I definitely need to design a clock for my own home. So this is the reveal of the clock for my client, which I'm really excited about. I think it's amazing that I was able to take two pieces of scrap wood that were used for two other projects in the past to be able to turn it into this gorgeous clock. She will be adding this to her kitchen space, and I'm honored that she's gonna have this in her space because this is someone that I know personally, and it just means a lot to me that she'll have something in her house that I created for her. And I think it turned out just the way she wanted it. I hope this video inspired you to create some of your own upcycled projects. It really is amazing what you can create with just a few supplies you can even find around the house. I didn't have to spend any money to create this aside from the under $7 that I purchased for the little clock movement kit. You could even find an upcycled or vintage clock and remove the hand mechanism on that and use it for your own. Because I wanted to make this for a client that would last for years and years and years, I didn't want to risk it and, you know, test out any vintage clocks. So I bought a new kit, but for the price that I paid, this was a really inexpensive project to make. And if I think about how much people actually charge for these to be recreated, the prices are super high and you really don't have to spend a lot of money to create your very own. Plus, you can add your own personal touch to it, which I think is exactly what my client wanted me to do with this piece. I showed you in this video how I used my scroll saw to be able to create a round shape for my clock. Don't forget that I have a playlist of 3-part series alternatives on how you can make round shapes for your own projects. Check it out in the link below. If you missed my last video, you want to make sure you head over to my channel main page and click on my video that I just posted. We just got a new addition to our family, which we're going to be doing a full renovation on. I think you'll be pretty interested to see what we're going to do. If you're like me and you love DIY, thrifted, and upcycled, you want to make sure to smash that subscribe button. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys, and I'll see you on the next project.